Peter Serva-Mugisha, the Managing Director of National Water and Sewerage Corporation. And I've been in this position for the last 7 years, coming to 8 years now. I've seen so many things happening in National Water. And mind you, National Water is comparable in terms of the way it operates, in terms of the environment it operates in, is comparable to many utilities in Africa. There are many challenges African water and sanitation utilities face, and one of the biggest challenge that needs attention is the issue of non-revenue water. And what does non-revenue water mean? Non-revenue water means that part of the water where water is put into the system. Some of it is sold in terms of revenues to the customers, and some of it is not able to be accounted for. In other words, there is no revenue from that water. So you have the input water, and when you go to the output, you can only account for some of that water in terms of revenues, and the other one is non-revenue water, expressed as a percentage of the water which was put into the system. National Water's level of non-revenue water now is about 25%. For the other regions, National Water has four regions: the north, the east, the central, and the west. Those ones have an average non-revenue water of 25%. But Kampala, which is the capital city, has non-revenue water of 35 to 40%, which is quite high. And there are so many things we are doing, especially in Kampala Water, to have it reduced. And therefore, the purpose of this presentation is to share some of the thoughts, some of the ideas, and some of the lessons we have learned in addressing this non-revenue water, especially in Kampala, and to some extent other big towns of National Water, like Mbarara, like Jinja, Entebbe, Masaka, Mbale, and other places. Now, so we're going to be dealing with a topic of non-revenue water in complex operating environments. And what does a complex operating environment mean? It is an environment where the utility is operating with a network which is largely in unplanned neighborhoods. There is no proper urban plan that you have to follow when you are laying pipes, and therefore you lay pipe somehow in a constrained environment. It is also an environment where you have technical staff that are still developing their technical skills and proficiency. They are not necessarily very good, they are not bad, they are still developing their skills. It is also an environment where staff have diverse values and beliefs, including those whose beliefs and values are at variance with the organization's objectives. And therefore, you have incidences of rent seeking in the field there, some staff wanting to do illegal connections so that they can get their own money without, revenues going to the organization. Now, what do you do, or what have we done in National Water to address this animal called non-revenue water, especially in Kampala? The beginning point is you must realize and quantify the problem of non-revenue water. That's why I'm able to say in Kampala, for example, Kampala City, the non-revenue water is about 35 to 40. So it is quite high. We have a database that is able to tell us this. And in other regions, it's about 25%. And once you have quantified the problem, the other thing is to make it part and parcel of your key priorities and for addressing, making sure that whatever you do, all the priorities you have, addressing non-revenue water is part of that. And when you look at the main causal factors, if we've tried to find out and relating it to the Iowa's water balance model, the main causal factors of non-revenue water in utilities like national water, and indeed I think in other utilities in Africa, the main one is illegal consumption. You have people, customers, sometimes assisted by the entity's staff, who tap connections before the meter, and they consume water which is not metered, water which is not known to the entity, and therefore contributing heavily to non-revenue water. Actually, this is, we suspect this is the biggest component of non-revenue water in most of the African utilities. The other aspect, the other causal factor is the issue of meters. Meters which are under registering, and therefore there's a lot of loss in non-revenue water there. The other factor is the authorized consumption. Most of the utilities, national water and other utilities in Africa, have fire hydrants in the network. These fire hydrants, the police authorities are authorized to get water from there for firefighting. Yes, if it is for firefighting, it will also contribute to non-revenue water. In other words, water which is used but doesn't give you revenue. The other water, of course, will be fetched from the fire hydrants with some of these authorities, but it will not be used necessarily for firefighting because there are not many fires that happen in these cities. But because you cannot predict when a fire will happen, the standards of installing networks is such that you have to put fire hydrants for that purpose. And there is a lot of abuse. There is a lot of abuse on fire hydrants of national water. There is a lot of abuse of fire hydrants, I'm sure, for all the utilities in Africa. So that's another source of non-revenue water. The other one are people who get connected and then their accounts are not captured into the billing system. And therefore, they are there, they got the water legally, but there's a miscommunication between that process of installing the connection and also capturing the connection in the billing system of the utility. So those people will be consuming water, they got it legally, but it is not captured in the system, and therefore it also contributes non-revenue water. So these are some of the key causal factors of non-revenue water, especially in national water and also in other utilities. So there have been some people who have come up with technologies, and if they find you not clear on some of these causes, they will just sell you this technology and deceive you with all the marketing language and say it will reduce non-revenue water. And what happens? You pay the money, you install the technology like prepaid meters, and after a few years, non-revenue water has not reduced, you have already paid, and that becomes a sunk investment with no value for money. So non-revenue water starts from realizing the actual causal factors, and if you are lucky to professionally suspect the main causal factor, it then becomes easy to address non-revenue water. The bigger aspect of nanowrapper management is about pressure management because some of these causes, like the leakages, the bursts, which are normally categorized as technical or physical losses or physical aspects of nanowrapping water, can best be handled if you manage the pressure in the network. Now, there is also having a system of district metering the network in such a way hydraulically, this one I mean by having those zones in such a way that you can be able to know what happens in this area and what happens in the other one, so that if you have a non-revenue water, for example, of 40%, you know which zone is the biggest contributor and which zone has the lowest amount of non-revenue water. Most utilities, especially in the developed countries, have zoned their networks, and it is easy to manage non-revenue water. In national water, this is something we are now doing through a big project which is ongoing, and when we do that, we should be able to account for our network and know which part of the network is causing big amount of non-revenue water. And normally, the indicator, if you have a lot of non-revenue water, a lot of leakages, it might also mean that the network is old and maybe it needs to be replaced by a new network in order to reduce this non-revenue water. But of course, the whole question of economic level of non-revenue water management, it comes in. There is a level below which, if you want to reduce non-revenue water, you will be spending much more money than the benefits you are actually expecting to get by reducing non-revenue water. So it is also important that utilities like National Water determine the economic level of non-revenue water so that we can be able to optimize the investments we want to put into reducing non-revenue water. Now, that was the bigger and the bigger infrastructure solution of how non-revenue water can be reduced. Now, I want to dwell on some of the quick wins that we've tried to do in national water to reduce non-revenue water. One of the quick wins is to raise a red flag. You have to raise a red flag and make sure that this message of high non-revenue water cascades to all levels of staff so that everybody gets involved. And also to tailor incentives to reducing non-revenue water. In National Water, for example, our incentive formula is such that reducing non-revenue water gives you an incentive, a monetary incentive, if you work towards achieving the targets or if you make positive steps to reduce non-revenue water. Then also continuously evolving practical solutions. Recently, for example, in National Water, most all our staff are involved in house-to-house audits of checking how the meters are functioning, whether they are illegal connections, whether they are leaks, and making sure you do it house to house. And when you get all those anomalies, you find a way of rectifying them, and that is now helping us to reduce non-revenue water in the organization. Then, having a way of auditing. House to house is a way of auditing what the other field staff have been doing, but also designing innovative, high impact auditing processes to make sure that if the field staff are working, they know that somebody else will come and check on how they have been doing their work. Then also being clear on the incentives and disincentives. For example, being clear on what will happen if the staff do a good job to reduce non-revenue water, and also what will happen if they are caught or if they are implicated in propagating activities that increase non-revenue water. The management team has to be very clear on the kind of incentives and disincentives that will happen. And also working on staff attitude and values. What we are doing in National Water is to take people for refresher courses, take people for mindset change training, so that we make people realize the dangers in getting involved in illicit activities that propagate non-revenue water, and also to make people realize that their survival depends on making sure that the corporation performs very well, which includes reducing non-revenue water, among others. Then, lastly, talking about the effects of high non-revenue water all the time, raising awareness in the organization, making sure that everybody knows why non-revenue water should be reduced. First of all, how it should be quantified, how it should be identified, and also what are the effects of high non-revenue water. The last point I want to discuss, and which I would encourage everybody who wants to really reduce this non-revenue water, is to be able to assess the development levels of staff and managers. They are unit managers that are not strategic in thinking, who will easily do what they are being told to do. Now, such people are good, we need them, but you always need a core team of strategic thinkers, people who are going to direct these managers what they should do in order to ensure that non-revenue water reduces. And also continuously guide the staff, continuously discuss with the managers, continuously learn from the lessons they have got from the field, and then continuously think of new ways of reducing non-revenue water. So non-revenue water in African water utilities is manageable, but it needs to be given the profile it deserves, it needs to be addressed, it needs to be tackled aggressively in order to reduce it to acceptable levels. I thought these are some of the tips one can use to tackle the issue of non-revenue water so that we can make our utilities in Africa more efficient and more effective and leverage more revenues, more finances to finance investments to reach more customers so that we can work towards achieving SDG 6. Thank you.